Well, hello, 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 everyone out there in Tarot Land. This is Zengaya, your Zen Libran, and welcome, welcome, welcome to my channel, Zen Libran Tarot. How y'all doing out there? Peace to everybody. How you living? How you living? How you live? I hope everybody's doing swell. I hope everybody is peaceful. I hope everybody has love and joy in the life. And I hope you're just vibing high. All right? All right. If this is the first time you join my channel, on my channel, I focus on the woman. I focus on empowering women to get back to their goddess status, their empress status, so that we can get back on the throne and rule this earth as we were designed to do. The earth is the mother's kingdom. It was designed to be ruled by the matriarch. That was when we were in our golden ages. But since the man has taken over, it's been ruled with death and destruction. We are the true kings, ladies. You know what I'm saying? King being a feminine word. Look it up. Research the word king. It's a feminine word and it means to rule with love. You know? And that's what we were sent here to do. This is the planet of love. The planet of love. The energy of love that is used to keep the narcissistic energy, demonic energy at bay in prison. This is a prison planet, ladies, and we are the wardens, you know. We need to lock them back up, y'all. We need to lock them back up. And in order for us to do our job well, we have to function at a high level, which means we need to heal. So, ladies, we are focusing on self-love, self-healing, so that we can heal and take over our throne. Okay, because Mother Earth is calling off us. She needs us to lift the vibration of this planet. Okay, all right. Well, I am here today to do a general collective reading for the zodiac sign of Leo for the month of March. Now, what's going on with my Leo? Well, Leo. Oh, honey. You made a decision to detach from people and family members and relationships of the past, okay? And once you decided to detach from these family members, relationships from your past, toxic patterns, toxic behaviors, your stability started flowing, okay? You are in harmony, you're in balance, and when you're that way, stability comes into your life, okay? Good for you, Leo. I'm so happy for you. You actually freed yourself. Okay? A lot of people don't understand that they be going through financial trouble and everything because of blockages. Because you need to do work on yourself. You know what I'm saying? You need to cleanse your energy so that you can attract wealth and abundance into your life. That's something that you have to work to do. You know what I'm saying? If you don't do that and you out here looking for a wealth and abundance, that means you're thirsting after it. Then you run across things that you shouldn't be doing. That means that you're susceptible to doing things that you shouldn't do it just to make it to the top or just to make money. You know what I'm saying? That's when you go and be taken advantage of by the dark side. Okay? See, that's why you want to do the work. Okay? So that your temple can attract abundance into your life, okay? And that's what this Leo has done, because she has become in harmony with herself, detached from people that were just lowering her vibe, family members, toxic behaviors, toxic patterns, toxic relationships. And she left that and became harmonious with herself. Her stability started to flow. You know what I'm saying? This is a decision that you have to make in your life in order to elevate sometimes. I was just talking to my niece and I was like, sometimes you have to, if you can't get enough people around you that have the same mindset, then you need to detach from the people that you're dealing with. Because when you elevate mentally, they're lower than you. And in order to get along with them, you actually have to lower yourself in order to get along with them. Okay, so it's nothing wrong with being around people without the same mindset, but not often. You know what I'm saying? That's why a lot of chosen people detach and they are in hermit mode. You know what I'm saying? Because the enough conscious people are not available. So you have to spend that time with yourself. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, that's what's going on with my Leo. All right. All right. And of course, this is the Goddess Channel. I speak from the woman's aspect and I pull from the feminine energy. And the feminine energy that I pull to help me deliver this message to my Leo is Kitesh. Kitesh is here giving us the energy of sacred lust. You have somebody that is lusting off your sacral energy. That means that they want to have intercourse with you. Okay? To get your energy. Okay? To tap into your emotions, to tap into your creativity. That's what they're lusting after. Okay? These people want to have a breakthrough. They want a rebirth with you. Okay? This is somebody that you was attached to in the past. You was somebody you was intimate with in the past. And they want to have a rebirth with you. Okay? They want your sacral energy. They want to have sex with you so things could break through in their life. Okay? They want to use your sacral energy to manifest things in their life, to get their life in the right direction. Ain't there nothing? This is my girl Kitesh giving us the energy of sacred lust. See, you have to be careful, Divine Feminine, who you're being intimate with, because people are energy vampires, and that is what you're dealing with right now. Okay? All right. You have been emotionally uncomfortable. Uncomfortable with this whole situation of this particular person trying to control you, to gain control of you so they can be intimate with you and get your sacral energy. You can't believe that you're being spiritually attacked for what's between your legs. Believe it, Divine Feminine. Believe it. You know what I'm saying? It's sad but true, y'all. You know what I'm saying? But you have been uncomfortable emotionally. It's been making you uncomfortable. You've been going through it, okay? But you stood in your power. You stood in your power and you kept your distance from this person. Actually, you retreated from this person and you stood in your power. Your yay is your yay and your nay is your nay. And you said no, and no means no. Do you understand me? You know, this person is very controlling. This is a narcissist and he demands that you give him intercourse. He has his nerve, y'all. He has his nerve. Don't let nobody bully you into having sex with them. You know what I'm saying? I mean, how dare you? You know what I'm saying? Yeah, it's this Knight of Swords that has been attacking you, spiritually attacking you, because you won't sleep with them. Because you won't sleep with them. Your ancestors have been guiding you to separate from this particular person. Your ancestors have been guiding you to separate from this particular person, and you did. You separated from this particular person, and you started living in your purpose. Okay, in your life purpose, you went and got in your North Node. Okay, you know you have a cosmic connection, and you know your purpose. You're in your North Node. You're not thinking about what this person is talking about, and he is upset because he wants intercourse. Okay, forget what you got going on. Forget that you got a purpose. You pay attention to me. I want intercourse. I mean, this dude got a serious problem. And your ancestors are like, leave this fool alone. Leave this fool alone. And you're like, okay. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, he's upset, honey, because you guys have a contract in the ethers, have or had a contract, and you're not paying attention to it. You acting like y'all ain't got no contract. You blind to it. You don't care what he talking about. Who are you? I'm not having sex with you. I'm not finna be in no connection with you. I don't want you. And you're not seeing this connection. And he's mad. He talking about we got a contract. We got a contract. But did we have a contract when you were doing other things? Now that I'm manifesting, here you come. You know what I'm saying? Here he come. You know, this person wants you to be in a commitment with him, but you're rejecting this person because you have risen above this particular person. This person, like I said, this person is in a low state of mind. Okay? He's in a low state of mind, a low vibration. and you have elevated. So you will not lower yourself to come back down to his level. See, this person is a knight. He's not even a king. You know what I'm saying? Less known than emperor. You know what I'm saying? So he has a lot of growing to do. And you're not going to lower yourself because he decides not to elevate. You know what I'm saying? So you're not paying attention to this contract. Not at all. You could be a Libra. You don't give a damn about this contract because he didn't give a damn. You're elevating and you're leaving his ass behind. Okay? You know? And this person is trying to bully you. Actually trying to bully you into getting in a union with him. And you know why he wants to get in a union with you? Because prosperity began for you. Mm-hmm. Your ancestors have gave you a spiritual inheritance. Prosperity begins with you. So he wants you to pay attention to this contract y'all supposed to have. You know what I'm saying? This person is out here using control tactics. Using these tactics to try to control you. Spell work. You know what I'm saying? Because he wants to partake in what you've worked for, what you've earned. See, he hasn't elevated and done any work. Nothing on his behalf. He's coming empty-handed. And he wants you to actually lower yourself and share what you get with him. When he's not trying to get nothing, he's lazy, not motivated, and you're not thinking about his ass. You know what I'm saying? Get on out of here. You know what I'm saying? You are a shaman. You are a healer. You could be a psychic. You could be a mystic. Indian. You're from the Indian culture. Egyptian culture. Of course, the Egyptians begat the Indians. Okay. This is you. Okay. You're having, attracting a lot of people. You could be on some type of platform. You are some type of truth teller. You're expressing the truth. You're also a healer or a psychic. You could be a reader like me. Okay. You're attracting a lot of people with your truth. Okay. And the way that you express yourself. Okay. This is what where your prosperity is getting earned from. I'm just hearing. Yeah. Mm-hmm. You're out here teaching people. Okay. You're some type of teacher, a healer. You're out here teaching people. People are learning things from you. Okay. They're learning things from you. You're reflecting on your life. You're reflecting on your life in the circumstances and situations and experiences that you had, and you're teaching people from the reflections of your life what you've learned. Okay? Yeah, that's what you're doing. And this is how you're forming a stable foundation. This is you some type of advisor, motivational speaker. Jupiter is in your house, okay? Is in your reach. Jupiter is in your energy. You know what I'm saying? Which means you're going to have luck, expansion, abundance. You're going to have a new beginning. You know what I'm saying? Things are going to take action in your life very quickly, and Spirit wants you to have the courage to get through it. That's why you have been through these tests and obstacles, because the Spirit is getting you ready for the level that you're actually, the next level that you're actually leveling up to. Okay? All right. We got a teacher in the house. You know what I'm saying? Yes. Okay. This particular person, this Knight of Swords that has been attacking you spiritually because you don't want to honor the contract you have with him, this is your twin flame. Okay? This is your twin flame. All right. This person wants a renewal with you. The spark you guys had in the past, this person wants to renew that spark. But this person needs to heal. This person has a lot of inner child wounds that he needs to heal. Like I told you, he's a knight and you're an empress. So he has a ways to go. And he just wants to just arrive there without no work. It's not going to work that way, babe. You have to put in your work. You have a lot of inner child wounds you need to heal to even get on her level. And you need to get to work or leave her the hell alone. You know what I'm saying? Because she's detached and she's not even attracted to you. So you got to do the work to attract her. All right? That's what's going on. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, this feminine out here had gonna have all her wishes fulfilled. You deserve it, honey, because you sitting up here going through a struggling time because you won't have sex with somebody. You refuse to have sex with somebody, and this person is having a fit and is attacking you. Attacking you for your holy cup. Attacking you, honey. You hear me? You're going to get all your wishes fulfilled. Prosperity is beginning in your life. And this is triggering your twin flame, well, your ex-twin flame. Okay? He wants a reunion, and you're getting all this prosperity, and you're still being guarded to him. And he don't like that. But you know what we say to that? Duh, well, take your ass somewhere and heal. Take your ass somewhere and elevate. Because she's not going to lower herself for you. That's why the divine is letting her out of this contract and giving her prosperity and leaving your ass behind. Okay? Goodness, you know? Let's get some tarot out here, y'all. Let's get some tarot out here and let's see what else the universe has to say about what's going on with my Leo. You're free from this person, honey. You are free. Things are going to change in your life quickly. Okay? Quickly. Yes. This person is like Night of the Living Dead. You know what I'm saying? A straight up vampire. And this person has been holding on to your energy. You know what I'm saying? I mean, like a scald dog. I mean, he's so thirsty. You know, I mean, this is a trying time for you. You know what I'm saying? He won't leave you alone. You know what I'm saying? He's attacking you for your sacral energy. You know, this person wants to get you naked. You know what I'm saying? And just beat the brakes off your ass. You know what I'm saying? So he can just be out in your sacral. I mean, please go away. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. This patient is being, you know, the divine wants you to have patience because they finna get rid of this person for you. They finna handle this food for you. Okay. Your image is getting ready to change, divine feminine. Just be patient. You are going to be, people are going to see you as this oracle. Okay. Your ships are coming in. Your finances are improving. People are going to be asking you for your services and also paying you for your services. And you're going to have other people recommending you, vouching for you. You could be traveling, going overseas, seeing people. They're requesting your services. Everything is going to happen. And this is going to happen quickly for you, okay? And that's all because you walked away from this false twin. Okay, when you walked away from this particular person and closed your legs to this particular person, that's how you got this prosperity. You had to leave this person behind. This person was bringing you down, and now you're positively moving forward. Okay, you're going toward the sun. You're in your higher self. You've activated your higher self by being in hermit mode, walking away from everything and everybody that was not helping you for your spiritual growth, and you did it yourself. You know what I'm saying? You activate your higher self on your own, okay? And this particular person just won't leave you alone. This person is crazy. You will never sleep with this person. And he just needs to go away. You know what I'm saying? Ridiculous. Embarrassing, even. Somebody can't take no for an answer. Don't nobody want you, dude. Go somewhere and heal and elevate. You know what I'm saying? You're not finna attract no empress. Go away. Ugh. This is somebody with low, terrible energy too. Oof. Go away. Sorry about that, divine feminine. Oof. His energy stinks. You know? Oof. What we got here? Yeah, this person here, man. I mean, he's showing up as a knight and a page. I mean, ridiculous. This person want to be in your life so bad, he don't know what to do. And he's spiritually attacking you, but he can't defeat you. he can't defeat you because you battling his ass. I mean, what he this you? You like, come on with it. You ain't finna beat me, boys. You drawing your sword. You know what I'm saying? And he don't know what to do because he want to be in your life. And you fighting him. You fighting him. Yes, go ahead. He want to be in your life and you ended it with him. You don't want nothing to do with him. He's not going to defeat you. You ended it. That's it. Okay? He's lustful for you. This is some person that is sending all type sexual energy your way. Okay? This person, he wants you to go back to your past where you was lustful. Okay? But you're not, you elevated. You're not like that anymore. Okay? You was like that when you and him, when you attracted him. You not on that no more. You've elevated your state of mind, but this person has not. Okay? He's over there doing spell work, sending sexual energy your way so you can sleep with him, so he can get your sacral energy. And you blocking it. You know, you was like, you's not going to be in my life. I do not want you. I'm not opening my legs to you. Okay? You know what I'm saying? You're not going to heal this connection with this person. You're moving forward. And you in battle mode. You're not thinking about his ass. Okay? He's not going to get his... You're not in healing nothing with him. He's not going to get his wish fulfillment with you. And that's to sleep with you. Okay? You're not reconciling with this person. And all he can think about is getting you in a connection with him. So he can benefit from your sacral energy. And he's putting all his time, effort, and energy into doing this spell work to get you to sleep with him. He's so sorry, girl. He's so sorry. I mean, you know, I mean, that's sexual assault, man. You know what I'm saying? He's assaulting you. Trying to get you to sleep with him against his will, against your will. This is ridiculous, you know? Let's get some positive out of here, because you've been being uncomfortable for a while dealing with this spell work from this particular person. Because you all because you don't want him. This is crazy, man. He needs to be punished. I mean, people like that out there exist, you know what I'm saying? You know? Spirit wants you to continue to love yourself. It's important for you to stay positive because beauty comes from inside out, okay? So stay positive. You know what I'm saying? Everything is happening in your way. Things are going to turn around for you. They are turning around for you. Prosperity is beginning for you. You know what I'm saying? A lot of things is going to take action in your life. You know what I'm saying? A lot of things is going to take action in your life, and you're going to be successful, okay? You're going to be successful, you know? Be strong, be fearless, be beautiful. You know what I'm saying? Have divine patience. Everything is going to work out in your favor. You know, this person is going to get his, okay? You just keep on moving forward, sweetheart. Keep on moving forward. Mm-hmm. Keep on moving forward. I'm so glad that you are. You know what I'm saying? I tell you. You have to, this is just what I told my niece. Sometimes you have to step away from people with these low vibing state of minds. You know what I'm saying? Because that clutters your energy. You know what I'm saying? It's not like you think you better. Or, you know what I'm saying, it's just you're elevating, and these people are on a low vibe, so you have to lower yourself in order to be around them. And aren't you tired of lowering yourself? You know what I'm saying? This card says, if you want to succeed, you should strike out on new paths rather than travel the worn paths of accepted success. You know what I'm saying? And that's another thing that I told my niece. Don't go on paths or let yourself live the way that you feel people feel that you should live. You know what I'm saying? Or where you should be. Do what makes you happy. Even though what makes you happy might not make everybody else happy. forget them. It's time for you to focus on yourself. You know what I'm saying? So why keep doing the same thing, going back down those same paths? You worn out those paths. It's time to take new ones. Okay? You know? Don't do what people think you should do that you know that people will accept. You know what I'm saying? What they expect you to do. Do what makes you happy. Okay? And that's what you did, Divine Feminine. You shut these people out of your life. You shut these toxic patterns, these toxic relationships, toxic family members out of your life. And you got in your purpose. Sometimes it takes for you to shut people out in order to do that. Okay? And that's what you've done. Okay? And that is loving yourself when you do that. Choosing not to lower yourself in order to fit in with the people that you shouldn't be around because they're not on your vibration. Lowering yourself. Okay? Don't lower yourself. Love yourself. Be strong. Be fearful. Be beautiful. If you want to succeed, you just strike out on new paths rather than travel the worn paths of accepted success. You keep going through the same cycle over and over again, doing the same thing. That's insanity. You know what I'm saying? I mean, come on, man. Do what's best for you. And that's what this feminine has done. And now she's teaching people from her life experiences, reflecting on her life. People are learning from her. You know what I'm saying? She's speaking about this experience of being under spiritual attack for her sacral energy. She's teaching women about sacral energy and spiritual attacks, how to protect yourself. She's a healer. She's a shaman. Okay? And this is her purpose. This is her destiny. All right? All right. Well, this is what I have for my Leo, guys. If you feel anybody could benefit from this reading, please, please, please share the awareness. Share the consciousness. Because we be going through a Divine Feminine, and we need to be around like minds in order for us to vent to people that understand what we're going through. Okay? It's comfort for us. So why not make yourself comfortable? You know what I'm saying? Stop lowering yourself. You know what you need to get rid of. Get it out of your way so prosperity can begin. Because that's a blockage. Even if it's family members or anything like that, they blocking you. Get their ass out your path. All right? All right. I love y'all. And I will see y'all on the next message. Y'all be easy out there, okay? Bye-bye.